Gentlemen, welcome to another Napoleon Total War. We have a 2v2 game here, the Galician Rhea, and let me introduce the players. From the right side, we have Crucible and Athos playing as Great Britain. Those guys are from the Unity clan. And here we got Aragorn playing as Prussia and Skarsgård on his left. So, let's start from these guys. We got some food gods around here, three in the numbers. This one is the 8th Life Regiment, and the Elite Regiment. We have 4 Light Infantry, the Prussian Fusiliers, an exceptional Light Infantry units. Musketeers, 2 of them, 3, 4, 5 Musketeers, 4 Light Infantry, and 1 Militia. We here, General Staff, we got Lancers, 2 of them, 3 Lancers, 4 Lancers, 5 Lancers. So, we got 8 foot infantry units, 3 of them the elites, 4 light infantry, and a militia and a classic general staff. Here, to his left, it's a Skarsgård playing as Prussia 2. We got 8th Life Regiment 2, we got 2 of them. Can count a couple of Prussian Fusiliers over there, militia, another Prussian light infantry over there. Four, that makes them 4. Probably the rules are no artillery, max 4 lights, and you got foot guards over there, musketeers. There is a musketeer over here, 2, 3 musketeers behind them, 4. So 3 and 4, 7, another 2 over there, 9. He got hookshots, one several. Let's go Freikorps, a general staff, and I'm not sure how many cap he has over there. So, from the opposite side, and playing as Great Britain, we got Athos here. Meanwhile, Athos, you sent me the wrong replay. This is not Tyrion Reeds and not Freelancer, it's 2v2. And we have 4 light infantry, 4 light foot. The 2 of them are Kingdom and Legion light foot. We got foot infantry, he's right. And the Connaught Rangers, 2 foot infantry. A foot infantry behind them, near to his left, another foot, 4 of them. What I was saying, okay, I was saying that this guy has a 4 foot infantry here, costume guards, and another foot, 2 foot infantry here. That makes them total 10, 11, something like that. This is his usual build. Light dragoons, 15 hushas, and another light dragoon, and a classic general staff. That's for Athos. And here we go to Crucible. He's gonna play as Great Britain 2. He brought a fencibles unit, that's a militia. 4 light infantry, the 2 of them, the King Gemma Legio Foot. 2 foot guards here on the left. And he brought 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 foot infantry and Highland foot. I think the Highland foot is a waste of money unless you want to make a charge with them. Classic general staff, dark dragoons, jungle guards, and I'm doing nothing here. Okay, let's roll, gentlemen. Let's roll. Okay. I think we're going to have action here. The hill. I love when that happens. You see that the Prussians, they do have an advantage over the British in the cavalry, but at the end of the day, if there's not going to be a teamwork, maybe the cav won't be so crucial to the fight, to the outcome of the fight. So we're gonna have some charge here that lances, but if they're gonna get themselves into the forest, the lancer unit will be useless. These guys, they're not good in trees and forest, because nice volleys from this guy. He's shooting his man at the back. Thank God they're already dead. Nice job from the Aragons, from Lancers, these guys. So, let's see what's going on over the battlefield. I'm gonna pause a little bit. I'm gonna pause this. And let's make a tactical analysis to what's going on here. So, you see that Skarsgård, he's dispatching an amount of his flank. The four light infantry, along with some musketeers. Probably, he's sending his troops around here to aid Aragorn's forces at the hill. At the same time, Athos is doing the same. He has an advanced flank, the four lights with the 4 foot, coming down as fast as they can around here. Probably they're going to match that Prussian flank, which they are coming to aid Aragorn's forces, while two of his foot infantry, they're heading directly to take the side of that flank. That's a quite good communication and cover from the two clan members. Meanwhile, Athos is going to keep his Connaught Rangers and some of his dudes around here. Probably he will try to stop the advancing, maybe the advancing Prussian lines from this side. Also, he's gonna keep probably his cap near to his lines and his general staff. Though the Prussian guy here, Aragorn, he got the numbers in cap, but he doesn't have the sufficient numbers in foot infantry units to attack the hill over here. I think he's going to be outnumbered by the British forces. And speaking of British forces, the British foot infantry is much better than the Prussian musketeers. These guys have an accuracy of 60 or 50 and reloading skill 60, something like that, while these guys have 50 and 45. That makes them, the British foot infantry, in a 1v1 much better. Okay. And also, I can see that Aragorn is gathering his light infantry over here. Okay, let me show you something, guys. Maybe you have to. You can't get all your light infantry over here because the terrain is so tricky. In order to use your light infantry units, you have to be around here. Okay, this is where the terrain is getting flat. It's getting flat. So, from both sides, from the other side, let me show you. Okay, from the other side is around here. That mean not here, here. That mean okay. The only flat area is from here to here. That means that you can make the jump here with the foot infantry as well. Maybe if you don't have the light infantry in a skirmish formation and have them as a regular foot infantry, maybe you can maximize your firepower by gathering only four light infantry to one foot infantry over here. Otherwise, your long range units, they are useless over the side. Okay. I have some other thoughts, but I will keep them for myself because I don't want to give all the secrets in the game. The same thing is happening here, so you're going to have the long range advantage if one of the players can push back the other out of the middle of the hill. Okay, so enough for the talking, let's see what's going to happen. So we got three elite Prussian units versus two over here in the Fencibles, and they should come around here and take a good position to shoot down that foot guards with their 120. So the first shots in the game, they are now, and probably they're gonna shoot that Fencibles. No. So Crucible has a very bad position here. You see the foot cuts over here, that's getting shots, side shots to that foot guard. Probably he's trying to fix his man, he already lost 5. And probably the food guys now, they're shooting at them. Two of them, two versus one. Not even the best player can win two food guys versus with one unit. So the British governor is the Light Dragoon, they try to charge. Nice charge, the Argon formed the square at the last moment, but we have action at the other side as well. So, Athos, oh sorry about that. Athos, he's not playing defensively, okay? He sent his light infantry units to meet the Prussians over here. Sorry about this, I had another phone call, so here we go. So, as I was saying, the British light foot, they are not stationary, they are trying to push Skarsgård's forces in the rear, though there is a... Skarsgård is occupying a very good defensive position, but his light infantry here, it's actually not in the best position, you see. The British troops, they have to come up here, and maybe then the pressure light infantry will be effective and shoot them, though. But these guys, if they will try to march up into the hill, they will probably minimize the losses, but from the position that the Skarsgård has, you see that they're going to cross fire the flanks of the British lights, okay? So, meanwhile, Skarsgård, he's probably going to send some units around here to help his ally, while his ally, as we speak, is outnumbered here in the hill. He got 3 units versus 1, 2, 3, 4 and 2, which they're coming, okay? Though there's a big gather of Prussian cavalry here, they're not taking the advantage to attack the British forces. Probably Aragorn. Yeah, Aragorn is busy fighting the British foot guards over there. So, as we speak, the 4 units and 2 of them over there are gonna be 6 versus 3, though this is gonna be a double team. And Skarsgård's forces, they are a little bit away from the main core.
Our men are running, sir!
As I can see, Aragorn, he's willing to advance his musketeers versus this British foot, but you see these guys, they're in a very bad position because they have to advance all over them, all the way up and meet the British troops. Otherwise, they're going to shoot, you see, they're going to shoot the poor ground. Sorry about this, guys, but I'm using a new keyboard and I'm sorry about the mistake with the camera. So, meanwhile, we have some poor foot guards here. They are getting destroyed by the British foot. The Christian, in some way, he managed to turn the fight over him and he broke his.
Our men are running, sir!
Over here, you see, there are two, but he already lost the defensives and one in the left over there. And I'm not sure how he's gonna react to that part of here, but these guys probably they are shooting with guards and have boost morale from the British general. So these guys they're not going to come back in the game. 45 in number, 23 now. So there's some so the food guards now they're pushing these food guards into square, so they're gonna get some food as far as they get food guards. And the good thing for Crucible is that the Prussian flank is actually weak. There's no unit behind them to support them. Okay, so here we have a cav charge here from the British cavalry. The British cavalry are trying to take down the Prussian cavalry, but they're going to get supported by the foot infantry. Though we have a midship here, probably they're going to attract the first volleys. Yeah, you see. These guys are shooting to the side and not be able to get pushing like differently, they could make a good deal of damage over there. But okay, I can't see what actually is going on over there. But somehow
our men are running, sir.
Yeah, somehow. Oh, they did. see, the lancers, they're not effective inside the priest. They could kill easily the King Timaligila through. They're still holding. You see that the mistake from Aragorn is that these guys actually they're shooting the light infantry and not the guards, while the target, the actual target, should beat the guards. And then, if he will be able to eliminate the guard units, then the
our men are running, sir.
There'll be no match for the lancers, the cavalry. The lancers are not good in trees, but they can do the job of killing the light infantry. Okay. So, I think these guys now, they're going to double or triple line, triple shoot that foot guard. So, as I was saying, that was the third phone call today. Not even the Ministry of Greece has so many phone calls in a day, oh my god. So, as I was saying, again, and I'm truly sorry for these guys, the Prussian flag is not supported with the foot infantry behind. So, there are some reserves here for the British, and though these guys are losing, they're not going to lose bad because
our men are running, sir.
Approaching the infantry, Aragorn, he needs to reinforce his right flank, otherwise he's going to shoot down by the British troops. And also, while these guys they are not doing anything, Skarsgård, he should try to use some reinforcements and to send to Aragorn. Actually, has to clear the side because probably Athos doesn't know what's going on over here and field guys over here, so Aragorn he could take these units out of there and make a reinforcement here on the right side. So then again here have another lancer charge, and this is wrong from these guys. Should not do that. Yeah. The first thing that you have to do is at least take one of the units to take them over there and try to reinforce the plan. You see, there are four
our men are running, sir.
Three, and another one of the five, and the general is nearby, the tribune guys are nearby. So now he's doing what I'm saying, the reinforcement thing over here, but now I think it's too late because no, it's not too late because I don't know what's going to happen, but if he would have done that before, then he could have easily destroyed, not easily, but he could have many chances, 60-65% to destroy the British flank. So meanwhile, there's nothing much here on the left. Skarsgård, he will try to push back the British forces if they retreat to the safest area around here. And now he's willing to shoot these guys down. And actually, he's shooting that foot from that range. Nice volley skill from Skarsgård. And he got some guards around here to help his ally. He's not moving inside the forest, but you see that the British lines here, there are four, and there are four Prussian lines around here. Also, they got the cap, so I don't think that these guys they will come out and fight in an open area, the guards and the musketeers. So another thing is that you have always have to check here in this map, in this particular map, what are you shooting at. Actually, the light infantry over here doesn't have a very good position, okay, because the line of sight is around here, and they can be accurate when the unit will be around here. Okay, so it's a waste of light infantry over here. They can be used in another way, but not there. Okay, so let's see what Skarsgård is doing versus Athos. So Athos, he does have a very good defensive position. His light infantry inside the forest. That means that the force will attract some of the enemy volleys. Let's see the line of sight. I love those close encounters. Yes, Meanwhile, I can count five like different greens.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if that is Casper, so maybe Argon is helping me. Maybe I made a mistake about the runes. I'm not sure. These guys, they are using the no ward for lights, while these guys, they are using the no ward five lights. I am with the five lights as well. Because if you are playing with four lights, then you are giving power to Great Britain, because if it's not supposed to play with lights, the game with lights, then you're going to minimize the firepower of Prussia and the strength of Prussia, because the strength of Prussia, besides the guards, is the light infantry. The musketeers are no match for the British for different way. So this is the formation from the two sides. Let's see. Let me open the minimap. So the Red Deutsch is the Unity, the Blue Deutsch is Aragorn and Skarsgård. Skarsgård usually is a natural attacker. I'm pretty impressed that he didn't move to overflank the British forces over here. He's really good at it. Maybe he's not aware what to do here in the 2 versus 2. The 2 versus 2 is different than the 3 versus 3. Actually, I prefer them. So we got some movement around here. We got the two musketeers trying to get in range to shoot that foot guard unit over there. These guards are almost in. They need 7 men to drop out the square from there, to drop the ability to form a square. So, these two dudes approaching these guys, if they don't have any room there, then it will be in big trouble. Yeah. Let's see it. Bad news for the guys. Bad news for the guys. So, we have some British light foot over there. Probably they made
our
a
men are running, sir.
Yeah, they're out of the game. So, okay, let's see what's going on. So here, probably here is what happened. Okay, we got the Argos forces trying to push the British troops over here. Now he's pushing with all he got. The British troops here, and maybe now Christian Blue will be in trouble. He's going to use his second boost of morale. While Skarsgård's forces, they will double team one of the British Lightfoot, but he pulled them away. So one of the British Lightfoot followed them, but probably Arthur didn't saw that coming, and his Lightfoot went too deep in the enemy lines and they were shot. So, meanwhile, here on the right side of the hill, Aragorn is trying to take down the remaining British troops, and they are 48. Okay, 48. One more, and these guys are
one of our units has used all its ammunition, sir.
Square. We have a British Lightfoot here, pushing. Nice job here from the British Lightfoot. And we have some. Actually, yeah, Crucible is in deep trouble right now as we speak, because he's outnumbered. He's not seeing that his troops here, they're outnumbered. So now he will try to reinforce with 150 from 3 and his dragon guards, his troops over here. So lancers, they're trying to take down that, I can't see, 26, and they're still holding them, impressive. But here we have action here as well in the center. We got the militia trying to beat
our men are running,
sir. The Mitchell. while the British light foot is, they are picking targets and they are shooting to the British light foot over here. So I'm not sure. Let's see. Yeah, you see what is going on. So these guys are moving again. Probably that's a glitch. Yeah. I'm not sure what's going on. That's a nice volley. Nice volley here from Russian light. So meanwhile, Krishnik is trying to hold his flank over here, but there is one danger for him. See that the center is weakened.
One of our units has used all its ammunition, sir.
These guys, they can combine with their troops. If Skullbutter will be able to send a cover around here, try to hit the Christmas forces from two sides, from here, and actually these guys, they can surround these guys. But Aragorn, he needs to get up over here as well, as fast as he can. So. Well, there is a mess around here, and I'm not sure what's going on. So, Krishnik is going to pull another unit here to aid his left, while Athos is he's holding Skarsgård.
Our men are running, sir.
I think he got the numbers here. His wall, his flank is well protected. I don't think that Skarsgård will be able to attack the flank, at least not yet. But if I was a Prussia, I would have told my ally to make a coordinated attack here on the hill. That would give a disadvantage to the British, because the British, they are trying to push the flank and try to push them back hard. And he keep feeding the flank with troops. And but instead of this, Aragorn, he will try to send some troops here on his right flank. So we have some depleted units over there. The Lightfoot is going to mill that British Lightfoot, and they're going to track all the fire. There you see. But these guys, the musketeers, they're shooting to these guys. So some games they came back into the game for Aragorn. Those men, they are back, and he still got some musketeers over there, but they can't really master the 120 foot. So Aragorn, he needs to retreat, while Skarsgård, he will try probably to attack to these British forces over here. But Athos, with a simple move, he's going to move forward his foot infantry, so he's going to make a three-line unit versus two over there. So he's going to get the upper hand in numbers. And probably the Prussian is going to get run out of ammunition. That's why he's going to melee them. He's going to charge them, absolutely, with these guys. So, Skarsgård is going to use his foot guards, and probably he's going to target one of these units over here. In a while, these guys are going to be... Oh, what's your goal? Nice charge here from the Let's Go Freikorps, and these guys now are in deep trouble with, because they are not able to form the square. Meanwhile, British, they are advancing from the hills, so they are going to push back the Prussians over there. While Great Britain has some troubles with the center. You see, these guys now under cap charge, and they can't do many things. But Athos, he still got two of his cavalry behind him. The British cavalry is over there, and we have a charge here over these guys. They're gonna form the square, but they're gonna charge them, pushing like different to hit, stop these guys from shooting at them. So, another charge from the Dragoon Guards, probably these guys are gonna form the square. But the British center here is in big trouble, they're almost eliminated. So, they might have some troubles here, because these guys now, they can surround the upcoming British troops, while these guys are gonna turn and face these guys, but these big distributors making a very good job. Also, this must be this. You see, there must be plenty of them, and we got the British guard behind the Prussian lines, and these guys are trying to take down the Prussian general. I'm sorry. But the musketeers turn to shoot that light dragoons, but these guys, they're gonna get fired by the Highlander foot. Okay. Sorry about this. I'm gonna pause because we have action all over the map. So let me start from here. While Skarsgård is pushing the British troops and he's trying to divide them by taking this flank to surround the forest, and while trying to hold his three units and watch these guys, the British players, they are countercharging to Aragorn's forces. We got the 1 foot infantry here with these guys over here. We have a foot infantry square from the Prussians, while the Dragoon Guards are trying to eliminate those Prussian fusiliers. Okay. So these guys are losing morale because they are under heavy fire.
Our men are running, sir!
So actually, with that British cap around, these guys now, they are disorganized and deep trouble. So the Prussian flank is actually in deep trouble. So here we have a rear charge here from the 50 pushers. Nice job, nice charge from the Athos here to the Prussian lines. We got some foot infantry in the square trying to save themselves, but at the same time the British flank trying to hold and shoot back these musketeers, while the British pushers are trying to harass all the flank over here. We got some stationary foot guards around here. I don't think that this foot infantry and the common rangers will be able to attack the foot guards out of speed. But now the attacker is becoming the defender. You see that these guys are under heavy fire. That was a good move from others, but As I see it, Skarsgård is recovering from that attack. Now he's going to countercharge his forces versus the British troops. Okay, pause. Meanwhile, the right flank of Aragorn is in a big trouble. Low morale, most of his men are rooting, and he's trying to save the remnants of his flank. He got only some musketeers which they have a morale issue, and they are going to get hunted down by the foot infantry and the foot infantry over there, while these guys, they are charged by the Highlander foot. So nice charge here from the Highland. That's a good use for the Highland, good charge. So I think that Aragorn is gonna lose for sure. Okay, let's see from this perspective. I'm not sure if Skarsgård is aware what's going on to Aragorn's forces. Otherwise, he would have retreated. Maybe, I'm not sure. So we have Sulu now. Okay, Athos, I see he's making his move versus the guards. The guards, the Dead Life Regiment, he's shooting to that foot. They almost killed 20 men at the first volley. And the bad thing for Skarsgård is not probably aware what's going on over there, while the British flank is ready to eliminate the Prussian flank over there and then turn and try to surround the Prussian center over here. So the Common Rangers now, they are marching the Aethelife Regiment, which they are losing plenty of men because they are 2 versus 1. Maybe Skarsgård is not aware what's going on here. He's not problem because his dudes, they are taking, they are under heavy fire. They dropped 56 men. You see how fast they are dropping, while Athos is using his last cavalry, his last British hushers versus the Prussians over there. So Skarsgård, he got 4 dudes versus 2. He's not playing pretty good here. He got a very close formation while he was trying to eliminate the British threat here with the British cav. But now his forces are actually almost surrounded by the British advancing on the flank. So if he won't move fast, then he'll be surrounded. You see that these two units are heading over here to cut off the way, while his 8th Life Regiment is dead. But the one thing that they can admire in Skarsgård, and the thing that I liked, is that he's a natural attacker, and also he's gonna stay and die like a man. A wonderful last stance from Skarsgård here. He's surrounded, but he's not quitting his ground. So, knows that the game is over for them. He can't do anything. Probably he's aware that many of his troops, they don't have ammunition. And he's trying to take down as many as he can. So, one general is down. And now the circle is closing. You see, the impossible troops from the other side, they came here. And now, he's outnumbered and he can't do many things. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was the game. I hope you enjoyed it. This is the last game that I'm uploading. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to upload some games of the 1v1 championship that I'm hosting. It's going to be a marathon. There are going to be plenty of games. Me and
one of our units has used all its ammunition.
We're going to cover that tournament. And links are going to be sold to when the first games will be uploaded. So, thank you all for watching. Thank you all for this wonderful game. And I hope we're going to see some good 1v1 games in the near future in the tournament.
We have killed their general, sir. Now they must break. Glorious victory, sir, is soon to be yours.